Здравствуйте. Hello and welcome to Russian language class. Before starting the new topics, let us have a quick recap of the topics that we had learned in the last lesson. If you remember, we had discussed about the possessive pronouns in the genitive case, how possessive pronouns decline in the genitive case. I have written a question here. Чей это рюкзак? Чей это рюкзак? Рюкзак is rucksack. How you answer this question? How do you answer this question? Это рюкзак моего друга. Это рюкзак моего друга. Here, as you can see, друга is in the genitive case, and the possessive pronoun мой has also changed its form in the genitive case. So мой has become моего. Similarly, if we change the gender of the noun, for example, сестры. Это рюкзак сестры. And if you add a possessive pronoun моя, моя will also change its form. It will decline in the genitive case as per the gender of the noun with which it has been used. So моя changes to моей, and мой моего. Similarly, наш нашего, ваш вашего in masculine, and ваша вашей, наша нашей in feminine gender. We had also discussed about the Russian names. So how many components are there in the Russian name? So I have written a typical Russian name here. Александр Александрович Андреев. We have already discussed that a Russian name consists of three components. The first one is имя, which is the first name or given name. The second one, which is here Александрович, it's a middle name or patronymic. So it comes, or it is derived from your father's name, and then comes familia. Familia is surname. So Александр is the first name or given name, Александрович is a patronymic, and Андреев is the surname. We have also discussed that how do we form the patronymic and the surname from the first name. For example, I have taken a first name Vladimir. So how do you form the middle name or the patronymic from Vladimir? If it ends with a consonant, we add the suffix ovich to get the patronymic. So Vladimir plus ovich Vladimirovich. This will be for masculine gender noun. And for feminine gender, we add the suffix ovna, Vladimir plus ovna Vladimirovna. So by adding specific suffixes after the first name, we derive the patronymic. And how many suffixes are there? Ovit, yevit, and eat for masculine, and ovna, yevna, inichna, and ichna for feminine. So this is all about the Russian names, and surnames also are derived by adding some suffixes to the first name. So this is about Russian names. Let's move on to the topics that we are going to discuss today. We have already seen the declension of nouns and pronouns in singular in the genitive case. Now we'll look at the adjectives. How do they change their forms in the genitive case when they are used with singular nouns? I've written a couple of questions here, and then their answers in affirmative, where we use the nominative case, and in the negative, where we use the genitive case. So we'll look at both the changes. So how do a nominative case form changes to the genitive case form? So let's look at the first question, first interrogative sentence. У вас есть новый учебник? У вас есть новый учебник? Do you have new textbook? Учебник, textbook. If you answer this question in affirmative or assertive, how will you reply to this question? Да, у меня есть новый учебник. Да, у меня есть новый учебник. Yes, I have the new textbook. But if you answer this question in negative, and we have already discussed that while replying a question in negative, we use the genitive case. The genitive case denotes negation. Niyat, uminya niyat novava uchyebnika. Here, as you can see, uchyebnik, which is in the nominative case, becomes uchyebnika in the genitive case, singular. And novi, which is a masculine form, becomes novava. So, we are only talking about masculine nouns here. So, uchyebnik, uchyebnika, novi, novava. So, what are we doing? We are replacing the ending of the adjective, which is I, ikratke, with o, ge, o, novi, novava. Let us look at our second interrogative sentence. U vas yest anglo-ruski slavar? U vas yest anglo-ruski slavar? Anglo-ruski slavar is English-Russian dictionary. Do you have English-Russian dictionary? So, what will you do when you answer this question in affirmative or assertive? Da, u menya yest anglo-ruski slavar. Da, u menya yest anglo-ruski slavar. Yes, I have the English-Russian dictionary. So, here Anglo-Ruski is in the nominative case. So, now let's try to answer this question in negative. Niyat, u menya niyat Anglo-Ruskava slavarya. So, here as you can see, slavar, which is again a masculine noun, has changed its form to slavarya. So, slavarya is the genitive case form of slavar. And Anglo-Ruski has become Anglo-Ruskava. Here again, as you can see, what we have done? We have replaced the ending of this adjective, which is e and e kratke, with o ge o, similar to the first sentence. Umenya niyat Anglo-Ruskava slavarya. So, wherever you find this ending, and if the stem ends with k, ge, khe, then we use o, ge, o at the end to get its genitive case form. So, let's move on to our third sentence, third interrogative sentence. U vas yest sini karandash? U vas yest sini karandash? Sini karandash, sini, as you already know, is blue. Karandash is pencil. So, do you have a blue pencil? Da, u menya yest sini karandash. If you answer this question in affirmative, we will use sini karandash, which is the nominative case form. So, let us try to answer this question in negative. Niyat, u menya niyat sinava karandasha. Sinava karandasha. So, here karandash in genitive has become karandasha and sini has become sinava. So, here as you can see, e and e kratke has been replaced with ye, ge, o. Unlike the previous sentences where we have added o, ge, o, and here also o, ge, o. So, whenever you have a soft ending adjective, we replace the ending with ye, ge, o. So, with the masculine adjectives, there are two changes that we do. We replace the ending with o, ge, o, like we have done in these two sentences, and ye, ge, o, if the adjective is the soft ending adjective. So, now we will discuss about the feminine adjectives in singular. Let us discuss about the feminine adjectives in the genitive case. So, how do feminine adjectives change their form in the genitive case? I have written interrogative sentence here and will answer this question in affirmative and negative. U vas yes chistaya chitraj. U vas yes chistaya chitraj. Chisti is clean. Chitraj, you already know, notebook. Do you have a clean notebook? Da u menya yest chistaya chitraj. Yes, I have a clean notebook. This was when we use chistaya chitraj, which is the nominative case. So, let's answer this question in negative. Niyat, u menya niyat chistaya chitraji. So, here as you can see, chistaya has become chistai. So, aya has been replaced with oi. So, whenever you come across an adjective with aya ending, it will change to o n e kratke in the genitive case. Niyat chistai chitraji. I do not have a clean notebook. Next interrogative sentence. Uvas yes sivodnishnaya gazeta. Uvas yes sivodnishnaya gazeta. Sivodnishnaya has been derived from the word sivodnya. What is sivodnya? Sivodnya is today. So, do you have the today's newspaper? Da umenya yest sivodnishnaya gazeta. Yes, I have the today's newspaper. So, here as you can see, I have used the nominative case because this is the affirmative sentence. Niyat umenya niyat sivodnishnaya gazeta. Niyat umenya niyat sivodnishnaya gazeta. So, here yaya ending has been replaced with ye and e kratke. So, this is what we do when we have yaya, which is a soft ending adjective. So, if the adjective is soft ending, what do? We replace the ending with ye and e kratke. And if the adjective has aya ending, we replace the ending with oi in the feminine gender nouns. Umenya niyat sivodnishnaya gazeta. I do not have the today's newspaper. So, this is about the feminine adjectives in the genitive case. Now, we will look at the neuter gender adjectives in the genitive case. Now, let us discuss about the neuter gender adjectives in the genitive case. So, how do they change in the genitive case? I have written a question here, like we have done with the masculine and feminine adjectives. Uvas yes svobodne vremya sivodne. Uvas yes svobodne vremya sivodne. Svobodne vremya is free time. So, do you have free time today? Da umenya yest svobodne vremya. Yes, I have free time. If you answer this question in negative, how will you answer? Niyat umenya niyat svobodnava vremini. So, here vremya has changed to vremini, which is the genitive case form of vremya, and svabodnaye, which has o and ye ending, changes to svabodnava. So, here o ge o, o ye has been replaced with o ge o. So, this is one of the changes that we do in the genitive case. So, if a neuter gender adjective ends with o and ye, we replace o ye with o ge o. Niyat umenya niyat svobodnava vremini. No, I don't have free time. Next question. Uvas yes sivodnya domashne zadanie. Uvas yes sivodnya domashne zadanie. Domashne zadanie is homework. Domashne has been derived from the noun dom, which is house. Damashne zadanie, homework. So, do you have homework today? Da umenya yes sivodnya damashne zadanie. So, here in nominative case, it's damashne zadanie. So, what happens when damashne zadanie is used in the genitive case? Niyat umenya sivodnya niyat damashneva zadania. So, here as you can see, ye and ye, which is the ending in the nominative case, has been replaced with ye ge o. Damashneva zadania. Zadanie, zadania. And damashne, damashneva. So, whenever you come across a neuter gender adjective form with ye and ye ending, we replace the ending with ye ge o. So, there are two endings in the neuter gender adjectives in the genitive case. The first one is o ge o, whenever the ending is o and ye, and the other one is ye ge o. So, if the ending is ye and ye. So, this is about the adjectives in the genitive case. I hope you must have understood how to decline an adjective in the genitive case in singular. The next topic we have is prepositions used with the genitive case of nouns. So, there are certain prepositions which are used with the genitive case of nouns with several meanings. So, some of the meanings we will discuss now. So, there are certain prepositions which are used to denote location of a noun, and they are used with the genitive case of nouns. For example, so what is the interrogative word with which we ask about the location of a noun? It is gijiye. Gijiye is where. Gijiye we believe chira. Gijiye we believe chira. Where were you yesterday? So, how do we answer? We have to answer denoting the location of the noun. Vchira my bili udruga. Vchira my bili udruga. So, here udruga denotes at a friend's place. So, yesterday we were at a friend's place. So, as you can see, u here denotes the location of a noun. So, location, my bili udruga. We were at a friend's place. And the noun after this preposition is used in the genitive case. So, drug becomes druga, udruga. Next preposition which is used to denote location in the genitive case is vozle. Vozle means by or nearby or near. Gdje stoit I vo dom? Gdje stoit I vo dom? Where his house is located? Ivo dom stoit vozle riki. Ivo dom stoit vozle riki. His house is located by the river. So, here vozle denotes by the river or near the river or nearby the river. Here one more thing is that vozle and u are synonymous in certain cases. For example, here you could have used u also. Ivo dom stoit u riki, by the river. The next preposition is okala. Okala also means near or nearby. For example, gijiye sijit ramesh. Gijiye sijit ramesh. Where is Ramesh sitting? Ramesh sijit okala riti. Ramesh sijit okala riti. Okala riti is near Rita. So, Ramesh is sitting near Rita. So, here okala means near or nearby. The next preposition which is used to denote location of a noun in the genitive case is vakrug. Vakrug is around. For example, gijiye sijiyat studenti. Gijiye sijiyat studenti. Where are the students sitting? Studenti sijiyat vakrug stala. Studenti sijiyat vakrug stala. The students are sitting around the table. So, we have discussed how many prepositions? U, vozle, okala and vakrug. There are a couple of more prepositions also which denote location, but about them we will discuss later on. So, u means at someone's place. Vozle is near, nearby or by. Okala is also near or nearby and vakrug is around. So, this is one of the meanings with which the prepositions are used with the noun in the genitive case. There are certain prepositions which denote place or the movement to or from a place, and they are used with the noun in the genitive case. Let's look at some of them. The first sentence I have written here is moi drug byl v Moskve. Moi drug byl v Moskve. My friend was in Moscow. So, this sentence answers the question gijiye. Gijiye byl vash drug. So, here I have used the prepositional case v and Moskve, in Moscow. Now, the second sentence. Sivodnya moi drug yezhet v Moskvu. Сегодня мой друг едет в Москву. Едет is from the verb ехать. Ехать is to go or to come, and it's a verb of motion. So it denotes the motion, and the question that it answers is куда. Куда is where to, and we have already discussed wherever we have the question or interrogative word куда, we use where prepositions ve or na and the noun in the accusative case. So, сегодня мой друг едет в Москву. Here, as you can see, we have used the preposition в and then Москва in the accusative case. So, а has changed to у, в Москву. Now, the third sentence. Недавно он вернулся из Москвы. Недавно он вернулся из Москвы. Недавно is recently. Recently, he came back or returned from Moscow. So, here is from. And the question it answers to is откуда? Откуда is where from? So, there are three questions here. Где, which means where. And you answer где with a noun in the prepositional case along with the prepositions ве or на. The second interrogative word is куда, which means where to. To answer this interrogative word, we use a noun in the accusative case along with the prepositions ве and на. And the third interrogative word is откуда. Откуда is means where from. So, whenever we answer this interrogative word, we use the preposition is or с along with the noun in the genitive case. So, basically we are now discussing about the prepositions is and с. Let's look at the next sentences. Вчера мы были на концерте. Вчера мы были на концерте. So, here again it answers the question где. Где вы были вчера? So, wherever the question is где, we use the prepositional case of a noun along with the prepositions ве or на. And we have already discussed that концерт takes the preposition на. Вчера мы были на концерте. So, yesterday we were at a concert. Next is сегодня мы едем на концерт. So, here this sentence answers to the question куда, where to. So, here we are using на plus the accusative case of the noun концерт. That is why концерт has remained концерт. Third question, third sentence we have is мы вернулись с концерта поздно. Мы вернулись с концерта поздно. So, here the sentence answers the question откуда. Откуда вы вернулись поздно? From where did you return? Late. Поздно is late. So, as you can see, wherever we are using на in the prepositional case, this с is used when we answer откуда. Similarly, wherever we use в to answer the question куда, we are using is to answer the question откуда. So, basically is, the preposition is corresponds to the preposition в, and с corresponds to the preposition на. So, if концерт takes на to answer the question где and куда, then we have to use с to answer the question откуда. Similarly, Москва takes the preposition в in answering to the question где and куда. So, to answer the question откуда, we will use is. So, is and с denotes the same thing, that is from. But the difference is на and в. So, is corresponds to в and с corresponds to на. The third preposition that denotes the place or movement to a place is the, which means the movement up to a certain point. Here, as you can see, I have prepared a diagram here, an arrow. So, when you move from one point to another and you are reaching a place or up to a certain point, we use the preposition the. For example, my yedim the vagzala. Vagzala is station. So, we are going to the station. Here, to means up to the station. So, we are basically reaching the point or reaching the station. So, these are some of the prepositions which denote place, movement to or from a place. So, now we will look at some other prepositions. Some prepositions along with the nouns in the genitive case denote time. For example, the preposition the, which means before or until, and posle. Posle means after. So, these are antonyms to each other. So, the is antonym to posle. For example, un chasta zanimayatsa dalyekci. Un chasta zanimayatsa dalyekci. Chasta is often, zanimatsa to study, the lekci, before the lecture. So, he often studies before the lectures. So, here as you can see, the along with the genitive case of the noun lekcia is used with the meaning time. So, it represents the time with the noun. The next is ani vstrechilis posle zanyachi. Ani vstrechilis posle zanyachi. So, they met after the classes. So, here as you can see, posle also denotes the time. So, these two prepositions are some of or few prepositions which denote the time. So, this is all we have for today. What all we have learned today? We have learned about the adjectives, singular adjectives in the genitive case. We also learned the prepositions which are used with the genitive case of nouns and various meanings that they convey. So, this is all we are going to learn this in this lesson. So, we will meet in the next lesson. Till then, spasiba, dasvidaniya.